write down water. Draw the orbital diagram of water molecule. Draw the orbital diagram of water molecule. Draw the orbital diagram. What is the hybridization of
sp3?
Sp3.
Yeah.
What all overlaps we have here? This is the hydrogen atom, and we have sp3 s overlap, sp3 s overlap. This is sp3 orbital which has two unpaired electrons. Okay, this is the orbital diagram. Water is polar in nature, polar, and it is a good solvent for polar solute, like dissolves like. Okay, polar solvent can dissolve polar solute. It exists as associated molecule, exists as associated molecules because of hydrogen bonding. Okay, now we'll have two different types of it, hard water and soft water. Write down, water which produces sufficient lather with soap is called soft water. Water which produces sufficient lather with soap called soft water. Next line, hard water. Hard water forms, hard water forms insoluble scum, SCUM. Hard water forms insoluble scum, before it forms lather with soap.
Which it forms lather after forming scum?
When all the ions which cause hardness precipitate out, then it can forms lather. Okay, forms insoluble scum before it forms lather with soap. Next line, write down reason of hardness. Reason for hardness. You must have done all these things, right? Ninth may be here. Okay. So write down reason of hardness. It is due to the presence of, in short, write down presence of bicarbonates and sulfates of calcium and magnesium ion.
Bicarbonates
and sulfates of calcium and magnesium ion. Two types of hardness. First one is temporary hardness. Two types of hardness. First one is temporary hardness. Temporary hardness, reason you write down. This is due to the presence of bicarbonates of calcium and magnesium. Due to the presence of bicarbonates of calcium and magnesium. Removal process for temporary hardness. Removal process, the first one is boiling. See, on boiling, what happens? Bicarbonates dissociate into its carbonate. Same reaction we have for MgHCO3. Okay, on boiling, bicarbonates dissociates into carbonates, which gets precipitated. Okay, so PPT of CsCO3 and MgCO3 forms. So first method is for the removal of temporary hardness is boiling. The second method is by Clark's process. Write down, in this method we use slate lime. What is the formula of slate lime? CLOH world twice. We use slate lime, which forms insoluble carbonate again. Okay, reaction write down, CaHCO3 whole twice. CaHCO3 whole twice plus slate lime, CaOH whole twice. It forms CaCO3 and water. CaCO3 and water. MgHCO3 whole twice plus CoOH whole twice. Water is CO. That's what I was coming to this point. You can also add CO for this purpose. When you add CO, it combines with water and it forms COH whole twice, which gives you the same.
MgOH is soluble.
This precipitates. Okay, CaO also we can add for this purpose. Either you can add slake lime or you can add CaO, because when it combines with water, it forms slake lime, and then we have the same reaction. Okay,
but I thought lime water was CaOH whole twice.
Yes, isn't it?
Lime water is this only, no? When this quick lime you add into water, you get CaOH.
Somebody just said it's slake lime.
The same thing, it's slake
when it's solid and lime water when it's liquid.
So
isn't it slake lime when it's solid and lime water when it's liquid? Like, it's called slake lime when it's solid.
See, molecular formula is this one.
Yeah.
Lime water is saying, it means this is present in water. That's why I've written this. CO in water gives you this. It means this is present in aqueous solution.
Oh, so it's like
in liquid. This is the solid. Clark's process, always remember this, in Clark's process we use CaOH whole twice for the removal of hardness. Okay, next slide down, permanent hardness. Permanent hardness. This is due to the presence of, this is due to the presence of sulfates and chlorides of, this is due to the presence of sulfates and chlorides of both calcium and magnesium. Sulfates and chlorides of both calcium and magnesium. Next slide. To remove this type of hardness, to remove this type of hardness, we use various substances, and these substances are called water softeners. The first water softener is, write down, washing soda. Write down, it removes both temporary and permanent hardness. By converting soluble calcium and magnesium compound. Into insoluble carbonates. Okay, so what is the product here? CaCl2 plus washing soda Na2CO3. It forms CaCO3 plus NaCl, right? MgSO4 plus Na2CO3, what is the product we get? MgCO3 plus Na2SO4. You can also write down the reaction of CaSO4 similarly, right? So it forms insoluble carbonates, that is CaCO3 and MgCO3. One note you write down. Write down next one note here. We can also use caustic soda, NaOH. Or sodium phosphate, Na3PO4. For this purpose. The next water softener is, two more we have, permutate. Write down. It is a common name of hydrated silicates of sodium and aluminium. Na2 Al2 Si2O8.H2O, XH2O, right? Hydrated compound. We also call it as sodium aluminosilicate. Sodium zeolite also. All are same. Sodium zeolite. This is used for the removal of both temporary and permanent hardness. Okay, this is used for the removal of both temporary and permanent hardness. The next one. Calcium. Write down. It is the complex salt of metaphosphoric acid. Metaphosphoric acid, the formula is NaPO3 NaPO3 6. The actual structure of this is Na2 Na4 PO3 6. This is a complex compound actually. Okay? It is a complex compound, coordination compound also.
So what's the thing behind coordination compound? What do they mean?
It's a one complete chapter. When you put this into water, then this will have one ion as this complete thing. Complex part plus 2Na plus. So complete dissociation nahi hota iska. That is the one thing. Another thing is here we have two types of valency. Primary valency and secondary valency. Okay. Ek ghante mein bol sakta hoon. It's not required. Ligand hota hai, metal hota hai, ionization is there, many things. So, all those things we'll discuss in detail. Right? But the only thing is, the definition of coordination compound or complex compound is, it does not lose its identity completely in the solution. NaCl ko daloge, so it will be Na plus aqueous and Cl minus aqueous. So NaCl completely converts into its ion. Okay? So that's the thing. Okay, so this is the third water softeners we use. This is useful for the removal of only permanent hardness. Permanent hardness. Okay. So this water softeners and reason for hardness, removal process, you must remember, it's very important for this one.